Welcome to No Rules Gardening. My name is Jim Putnam.
And I'm Bree Arthur. And today we are giving you an update on our Camellia March Madness Sweet 16 competition.
Yes, thanks everybody for participating. We have gone from 16 down to our final four matchups in the Camellia competition. We wanted to kind of go through and say what our four favorites actually would have been if we'd have been doing the voting.
Yeah, it's really interesting to see which plants have reigned supreme based off of a thumbnail picture on Instagram versus really getting into the dirty details of each cultivar. And so we've both been kind of shocked by some of the results. And I think the singles started off, we were thought we were on a roll, and then it became a surprise.
It definitely became a surprise because you're, how do you pronounce it again, Bri?
Haru no Utena. Yeah. I've practiced.
Right. That was the winner from the singles category. I think we both would agree that Crimson Candles is just the superior one of the four that we had. And keep in mind, guys, when we picked out the plants at Camellia Forest, we were picking 16 that happened to be in bloom that day. So, you know, we were kind of held to that. And then her and I were competing against one another for which ones we wanted as well. But definitely Crimson Candles, I grew this hybrid for years. And the one thing I know about that plant is if you're looking for a Camellia, it just won't let you down. I don't care whether you think you have a black thumb or whatever, it won't let you down. Whereas sometimes seasonally, our Camellia japonicas we can get frost and freezes and or it can just go to 85 really quickly, and that can be an issue. But Crimson Candles just never ever let me down.
I agree. I have one in my woodland, and it starts blooming typically around like Valentine's Day, so it's a really long extended season of bloom.
Yeah, so that would have been our pick, but we weren't picking.
We weren't voting.
So in the semi-doubles, where would you have gone?
Well, I think actually the choice for semi-doubles was on point with Taylor's Perfection.
Yeah, I agree.
And it's just a fantastic plant. But again, if I was going off of plants in my own collection, I would have chosen Royal Velvet as my pick for semi-double. It just wasn't in bloom the day that we were at the nursery.
Right. And why else other than, I mean, just the form of the whole plant.
The form, the plant, it's absolutely covered in these beautiful dark red flowers. The thing I love about this color is that it doesn't show frost damage.
Right.
Because like you said, we frequently are a yo-yo with our spring weather.
Right.
And so the lighter colors, the soft pinks and whites, you know, after you get, you know, to 30 or even 28 degrees, they kind of turn into a dirty tissue.
Right. So that's why
I like the dark colors better.
So the third category, our final four voted through was high fragrance. What would we have actually had as our final four?
I think Carter Sunburst should have won that hands down.
It's beautiful, and I'm surprised even from the flower photo that one. Even the photos, I thought it would have carried through, but I think sometimes plants get the proper name.
Yeah.
Sometimes plants get the proper name. There's plants like Frostproof Gardenia. It's no more frostproof than a lot of other gardenias. I think it just comes through as it must be more frostproof than the other ones are a problem somehow.
Yeah. I agree. I think with the thing with high fragrances, it does have an element of fragrance that is unusual for spring flowering camellias.
Right.
So it's a great plant.
Yeah.
I just think overall for landscape value, Carter Sunburst is the better plant.
Right, and we're definitely not knocking any of these. All 16 of these I'd love to have in my garden, and there's probably another 64 we could have picked out of there. They just weren't blooming at the time that were great cultivars.
I have 52 now.
She's 52.
In my garden.
I have 9 on my little 2/10 of an acre, and I'm probably will add many more before it's too crowded in that space. So let's get to the category that was the most, where we figured the overall winner would ultimately come from. And Lemon Glow came through in the formal doubles.
It did.
What did you think? Should we move over to Jax?
We should.
Okay.
We should, because my soul is crushed because of this.
All right, you guys. Seriously, you didn't choose Jax? Jax is the best camellia of all time. And it's not just because it has the most perfect flower that's ever been created. It's also because it's got this amazing habit. I've never pruned this. This has been in the ground for 10 years, and I have never once done anything to it other than, you know, give it a handful of holly tone in March and October. So this is a camellia that, whether you voted for it or not, you should include in your landscape because it has this dense pyramidal habit and beautiful form for year-round interest.
Make sure you're following No Rules Gardening over on Instagram. That is where the voting is taking place. Also, go back and watch the first video if you haven't yet. I'll link it up here in the corner.
And thank you all so much for participating in our Sweet 16. I can't believe we're down to the final four. You should see my tally log every day marking down who votes for what.
Right. Also, Bree created a blog post for that original video for the Sweet 16 Camellia Countdown if you want to know more about each variety. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, guys, and hit that little bell notification so you're alerted when we upload videos.
Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in the garden.